AYAs face a lot of assumptions in the healthcare system, and that ranges from lots of different things. Sometimes these young folks who are living with life-limiting illness have a lot of pain control issues, but sometimes they face assumptions because of their age that they just have drug-seeking behavior. A lot of them, because of their age, face assumptions that they're not going to show up for their treatment, right? Or that they didn't miss their treatment for a very good reason. So another major assumption that these young people face is that they can't handle the information, or they're too immature to handle the information on their own, or they can't really process what they're going through. But I don't find that to be the case at all, really. And but sometimes there's this assumption amongst healthcare providers that, oh, well, they just simply don't understand that they're dealing with a life-limiting illness or a terminal illness or an incurable illness. And sometimes I've been approached to have that conversation with younger patients. And in my experience, sometimes they might talk about, oh, well, maybe in 5, 10, 15, 20 years down the road in my life, I want to do this or that, right, with my life. But then almost in the same breath, they'll also recognize the serious health issue that they're dealing with. And so it's not, so when they're talking about 5, 10, 15 years down the road, that's not ignorance, that's not living in la-la land, right? But that's also sometimes just a way of coping and thinking about the future, right? Putting one foot in front of the other, coping day by day, but also giving them something to think about and hope for. And I don't think that's bad. I don't think we need to bring them back into the reality that perhaps their prognosis is 6 months or less, let's say, for example. But it's just about allowing them to cope in the ways that work for them.